Music with Missy Theer. Yes, it's gonna be real fun. We will work together now. One for all and all for one. You will learn to dance and sing. La 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 la. Oh, what joy the music brings. So get ready. Alrighty, second grade. So last week, if you remember, you got a chance to watch a few videos from one of my very favorite actresses in the whole world named Julie Andrews. And you saw a video from Mary Poppins, and you saw a video from My Fair Lady, and you saw a video from The Sound of Music. And in The Sound of Music video, you heard a song called the Do Re Mi song. It sounded a little something like this. Do, a deer, a female deer, re, a drop of golden sun. Does that kind of ring a bell a little bit? Awesome. So, today I wanted to talk a little bit more about that song and that do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do business that you learn in that song, okay? It's something very important in music called the solfeggio scale. Can you say solfeggio scale? It's very important because in the solfeggio scale, you can learn how to sing almost anything because it's got almost every note that we sing, okay? So it looks a little something like this. Let me sing it for you. And you may notice here, it might be hard to see on your screen, but there are all these cool hand signs. It almost looks a little bit like sign language. It isn't really sign language, folks, but they are hand signs that are kind of there to help your body remember each of the notes. If you want to try and do the hand signs, you certainly can. You don't have to. Some people find it hard to sing and do the hand signs together. For some people, it really helps. For some people, it doesn't. So don't worry about it too much. Let me sing it for you first. Are you ready? Do, re, mi, fa, so, la, ti, do. Now we'll go back down. Do, ti, la, so, fa, mi, re, do. Lovely. So I wonder if you notice as I was singing that as I went from the bottom of my ladder to the top, did you notice that the notes kept getting a little bit higher also? Sometimes people will call this a solfeggio ladder because it's like with every note, you're going up a step of the ladder, it gets higher. Or if you go down, the notes are going to get lower. You might have also noticed that there was a do at the bottom and also a do at the top. That's kind of tricky, isn't it? They're both do's, but they're different. We have do, do. They're almost the same, except one is low and one is high, okay? We can talk more about that another time. It's hard to talk to you about it when you're not actually here in my room with me. But there are two do's up there, friends, but don't let it distract you, okay? Let's try this. I'm going to do a few notes, and I wonder if you can echo them back. Are you ready? My turn first. Do, re, mi. My turn. Mi, fa, so. La, ti, do. Beautiful. Let's try the whole thing starting from the bottom and going up to the top. Ready? Do, re, mi, fa, so, la, ti, do. Now let's go back down. Do, ti, la, so, fa, mi, re, do. Beautiful. Okay, can you echo me? I'm not going to use this chart. I'm just going to use my own hand signs. Are you ready? Echo, my turn. Do, do, do. Do, re, do. Mi, re, do. So, so, so. So, la, so. La, di, do. Do, so, do. Do, ti, do. Do, re, mi, re, do. Fantastic. You guys are the masters of solfeggio. Bum, bum, bum. Okay, so. So, get it? That's one of our notes. I made a little joke, didn't I? Anyway, so. I have a fun little song. It's a little bit like the doe, a deer, a female deer, except it's a different one. But it's the same type of song in that it teaches us our solfeggio scale. It's called the Wacky Do Re Mi song. So I'm gonna turn it on. You're not gonna know it yet, but no worries. I bet you by the end, you're gonna know at least some of it. And you can practice your hand signs and practice singing those notes with me. Are you ready? Let me turn on the music. It's very groovy. Oh yeah. It's gonna start at so, and I'll guide you through it. Ready? So, mi, la, so, mi. And then we get groovy.
So, so, mi, la, so, mi.
Down to do.
Do. I make my cookies out of dough. Re. Like on a sunny, sunny day. Me. There's no one else I'd rather be. Fa. Sing out your fa la la. So like a solo. Whoa, whoa, whoa. La like a lava makes my lava lamp glow. Tea, have a cup of tea. Made of dough.
Back to so me, ready?
So me, la, so me.
Get groovy.
So, so me, la, so me.
Down to dough one more time.
Dough. I make my cookies out of dough. Red. Like on a sunny, sunny day. Me. There's no one else I'd rather.
Now it's gonna slow down.
We'll sip it with our cookies made of so me, la, so me.
Nice, you guys. Fantastic singing. Okay, friends, it is time to get up and move a little bit. And today's gonna be fun because we're doing a song called the Beanbag Boogie, which many of you might have done with me last year. Some of you may not if you're in kindergarten. But of course, when you do the Beanbag Boogie, you should be using beanbags, which is what we'd be doing if we were in my classroom. But we're not in my classroom, are we? So instead of using beanbags today, I thought it would be fun to use a stuffy. So your job is to find a stuffy you'd like to use. I'm going to use my daughter's unicorn. And yes, I got permission to use her unicorn. And when you find your stuffy, we're going to be balancing it on all these different places. So all you have to do, friends, is listen to the directions that are given in the song. Are you ready for the beanbag / stuffy boogie? Let's do it. I'm turning on the music. Oh yeah.
What
on your head, can you balance it? And can you move and groove is the question.
Now put your beanbag
on your shoulder.
Don't let your beanbag touch the ground. Now put your beanbag on your elbow.
On your elbow, uh-oh. You guys are doing great!
Now hold that
bean bag in your hand and
boogie.
Jump, and we're holding on to our stuffy as we jump.
Come on and jump to the bean bag again. Everybody jump to the bean bag.
Oh yeah, you got it, people. All right, let's listen.
Put your bean bag on your forehead.
Uh-oh, forehead. This is going to be hard.
Uh-oh.
Oh, this is hard. Ah!
Now put your bean
oops.
On your finger.
Uh-oh, your finger. Oh, dear.
Your whole self in the groove.
This is harder with a stuffy than it is with a bean bag. Woo-hoo! Maybe I'll do two fingers.
Oh!
On your ear, oh boy. You got it, people. Ah! In your hand. Oh yeah, we're shaking those stuffies. Oh yeah. Now we're listening. On your tummy. I'm gonna hold her. But if you wanted to lean back and try and balance, maybe you could. I'm not that flexible. So I'm just gonna hold it. On your back. Ooh, this will be tricky. Uh-oh. I'm just gonna kind of hold it. We'll pretend I'm balancing. You got it, friends. Uh-oh. On your knee, can you do it? Oh yeah, people. Oh my gosh, this is so hard. In your hand. Oh, stomp those feet, folks. Fantastic work, everybody. All right, folks, I'm really excited because I get to share with you one of my very favorite fall stories today. And it's a story called The Little Old Lady Who Was Not Afraid of Anything. And I think you'll really, really like it, friends. And the cool thing is, there's part of the story that you get to participate in at home, okay? There's an echo part, and I'll kind of teach you as we go how to do it. Are we ready for the story? Let's do it. It starts like this. Once upon a time, there was a little old lady who was not afraid of anything. One windy afternoon, the little old lady left her cottage and went for a walk in the forest to collect herbs and spices, nuts and seeds. She walked so long and so far that it started to get dark. There was only a sliver of moon shining through the night. The little old lady started to walk home. Suddenly, she stopped because right in the middle of the path were two big shoes. Oh my goodness. Now here's where we get to start the participation piece, okay? So I get to speak first. I'll say this, and the shoes went clomp, clomp. And your job at home is that you get to echo clomp, clomp. Now the trick is you only are echoing the sound effect piece, the clomp, clomp, not the rest of the words that I say, okay? And what I like to do also is I like to tap the table, clomp, clomp, to make a little sound like she's stomping. If you're at home and you're standing up, you could stomp or you could tap your legs, however you want to do it at home, okay? Can we try it? And the shoes went clomp, 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 clomp. Yeah, and so every time we do the sound effect, I'll do it two times. All right, are we ready to keep going? Do you think she's going to run into some other things on the path? Maybe. Let's find out. Get out of my way, you two big shoes. I'm not afraid of you, said the little old lady, and on she walked down the path. But behind her, she could hear two shoes go clomp, 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 clomp. A little farther on, the little old lady stumbled into a pair of pants. That's a silly thing to stumble on, huh? Okay, remember, I get to go first. And the pants went wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, wiggle. Get out of my way, you pair of pants. I'm not afraid of you, said the little old lady. And she kept walking on. But behind her, she could hear two shoes go clomp, clomp. Clomp, clomp, and one pair of pants go wiggle, 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 wiggle. Farther still, the little old lady bumped into a shirt. Oh my gosh. And the shirt went, my turn first, shake, 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 shake. Get out of my way, you silly shirt. I'm not afraid of you, said the little old lady, and on she walked. But behind her, she could still hear two shoes go clomp, 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 clomp. One pair of pants go wiggle, 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 wiggle. And one shirt go shake, 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 shake. A little ways on, the little old lady came upon two white gloves and a tall black hat. And the gloves went clap, clap. Clap, clap. And the hat went nod, nod. Nod, nod. Get out of my way, you two white gloves and you tall black hat. I'm not afraid of you, she said. And on she walked just a little bit faster. But behind her, she could hear two shoes go clomp, clomp. Clomp, clomp. One pair of pants go wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, wiggle. One shirt goes shake, 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 shake. Two gloves go clap, 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 clap. And one hat go nod, 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 nod. By now, the little old lady was walking at quite a fast pace. She was very near her cottage when she was startled by a very huge, very orange, very scary pumpkin head. And the head went, my turn first, boo-boo, boo-boo. This time, the little old lady did not stop to talk. She didn't stop at all. She ran, but behind her, she could hear two shoes go clomp, 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 clomp. One pair of pants go wiggle, 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 wiggle. One shirt go shake, 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 shake. Two gloves go clap, 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 clap. One hat go nod, 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 nod. And one scary pumpkin head go boo, 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 boo. The little old lady did not look back. She ran as fast as she could, and she didn't stop to catch her breath until she was safe inside her cottage with the door locked. She sat in her chair by the fire, and she rocked and she rocked. It was so quiet in her cottage before the knock, knock on her door. Should she answer it? Well, she wasn't afraid of anything, so she went to the door and she opened it. And what do you think she saw? Two shoes go clomp, clomp. Clomp, clomp. One pair of pants go wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, wiggle. One shirt goes shake, shake. Shake, shake. Two gloves go clap, clap. Clap, clap. One hat go nod, nod. Nod, nod. And one scary pumpkin head go boo, boo. Boo, boo. I'm not afraid of you, said the little old lady bravely. What do you want anyway? We've come to scare you, they said. Well, you can't scare me, said the little old lady. Then what's to become of us? The pumpkin head suddenly looked unhappy. I have an idea, said the little old lady. She whispered into the pumpkin's ear. The pumpkin head nodded and its face seemed to brighten. The little old lady said goodnight, closed the door, and whistled on her way to bed. The next morning she woke up early. She went to her window and looked out into her garden. And what do you think she saw? Two shoes go clomp, clomp. Clomp, clomp. One pair of pants go wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, wiggle. One shirt go shake, shake. Shake, shake. Two gloves go clap, clap. Clap, clap. One hat go nod, nod. Nod, nod. And one scary pumpkin head go boo, boo. Boo, boo. And scare all the crows away. So all those things she ran into on the path turned into the perfect scarecrow, didn't they? It kind of worked out nicely. I love that story, friends. Thank you for sharing it with me. Alrighty, second graders. So our final activity for today is actually really super fun to do, and it's also going to be part of your assignment for this week. So we're going to do something that I like to call draw what you hear. So all you need for this activity is a piece of paper and a pencil. So why don't you go grab those things really quickly? And then what's going to happen is I will play a piece of music for you, and your job is to listen and draw what you hear. Now, when I say draw what you hear, if you imagine watching a movie with your family, a lot of times when you watch a movie, there's music happening in the background. Have you ever noticed that? The music really helps the story. Sometimes it can make you feel happy or energetic or sad. And so when you listen to this piece of music, I want you to think that if there was a movie going on, what do you think would be happening on the screen during this type of music? And I want you to draw something. It doesn't have to be a beautiful piece of art. Miss Brestel's your art teacher. I'm not your art teacher. It doesn't have to be beautiful, but I want you to think about what's going on in the music as you listen to it. And then your assignment for the week would be to send me a picture of your picture and maybe a quick video explaining what you thought was happening in the music. Now, friends, there is no right or wrong answer to this. It's purely whatever you think is happening. Okie dokie, so I'm about to turn on the music. I think maybe you will have heard this music before, but we'll see. And I'm gonna draw a picture too, so you'll see what I come up with at the end as well. All right, here's your music. Thank you. goodness, the music is over. I've got to finish my drawing. Boy, this is not a very good drawing, friends. But that's okay. I'll share with you what I came up with. I drew some cute little bumblebees, and they're going from flower to flower. Have you ever watched bees do that? They're so busy, aren't they? When people say busy bee, they're talking about how bees go from flower to flower to flower so quickly. And so that's what I drew. And I confess to you, friends, that I knew the title of this particular piece. And it's a song called Flight of the Bumblebee. So that's actually what the song is supposed to be showing, is a bee going so fast from thing to thing to thing to thing, okay? Now, friends, again, there's no right or wrong answer. That just happens to be what the composer was trying to show when they created that song. But I'm curious to see what you thought was happening in the song. So again, make sure you send your pictures and videos, please. Thanks for joining me, guys. Bye.